What three-letter word goes in there?
Ice.
No.
Because of the, he couldn't expand because of the, what, Jackie? The lid. Well, his answer wasn't too far off. You know, his answer was related to the question, but lid is more suitable. Okay, but B couldn't because of the lid. So the blank, 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 blank broke B. Now, what word has that many letters that fits? It makes sense. Chase.
Expanded. No.
So the expanded broke me? Well, it's related, but it's not the right word. What word fits, Emily?
Pressure fits.
I hope it fits. Maybe I didn't leave enough blank. Once in a while, I don't make enough blanks, and then nobody can figure out the right word. Okay. The pressure broke B. All right. That's all you have to have on your record sheet today, right there. Okay, but we're not done because I'm gonna tell you some stories that are related to freezing water and pressure. Okay. When I was your age, 68 years ago, we had a guy called the milkman that delivered 1 gallon glass bottles of milk to our doorway. The bottles had a cardboard cap and a thick paper cap with a thumb notch. Some people used to call these fobs. Okay? The milk that the milkman delivered raw milk. You don't buy raw milk nowadays.
No.
Raw milk is the way it comes out of the cow. that's raw milk. Okay, the milk you buy in the stores today is mainly either non-fat milk or homogenized milk. When the milk comes out of the cow, the non-fat part of the milk and the cream are all mixed in together. They're evenly mixed in the milk. Raise your hand if you've ever had milk straight out of the cow. Anybody? Well, a lot of you have. You're country kids. But so in the schools where I teach in the city, I can't find anybody that has milk straight out of the cow. Okay, that's called raw milk. All right, that's the kind of milk we got. But the cream part of milk is fat. Cream is fat. And the low fat or the non-fat part of the milk is almost all water. Cream is fat, and fat is less dense than water. So what does the cream do if you let it sit for a while? Who can figure out what the cream does if you let it sit for a while? What does it do? It floats. Okay. So when he brought it to us fresh out of the cow, it was all mixed up. But when I went, he came before daylight. Hey, milk farmers have to get up really early. I wouldn't advise any of you to be a milk farmer unless you like to get up early. Okay. So by the time I went out to get it, just before I left for school, the cream had separated out. I'm going to draw green cream because I don't have any yellow. Okay. The cream had separated out and was floating on top. Okay. That was during what was called the Great Depression. Hardly anybody had enough money to buy cream, because cream is more expensive than non-fat milk. So that's how we got our cream. We carefully pour it off and use it on our cereal and coffee. Okay, the rest of this was non-fat milk, almost pure water. Okay, I look forward to freezing days when it got really low, like in the 20s, because by the time I went out to get the milk, the non-fat milk had frozen. Mm-hmm. So it expanded up to about here. How many percent?
8%.
What happened to the cream when the non-fat milk froze and expanded? What happened to the cream? What do you think happened to the cream, Janelle?
It came out.
It got pushed up. It got pushed up.
Did you see that?
So the cream was up like this, and the cap, the cap was sitting on top of it like that. Well, I call these chimneys. I call these chimneys because they look sort of like a chimney. All right. I didn't have any brothers or sisters, so I didn't have to compete with anybody for what I'm going to tell you about now. I would bring that in the house. I would scrape that cream off, that frozen cream off into a bowl, and I'd add sugar. What did I have? What did I end up with? What did I end up with, Harley?
Cream and sugar?
Brilliant, Harley. What's another name for it? What's another name for it, Janelle? No. What's another name for it, Darby?
Anna?
No. What's another name for it, Jessica?
Cream?
No. Emily?
Cream?
No. Frozen cream with sugar in it. What can you call it? Kendall? Ice cream.
Oh.
That's how I got my ice cream. Yum, yum. Hey, that was the best ice cream in the world. It was all it was frozen cream and sugar. Nothing harmful in it. If you buy a carton of ice cream in the stores nowadays, if you look at the ingredients level, there's about a dozen different ingredients that they put in, and most of them aren't good for you. They put things in ice cream to keep it from melting too fast and keep it from forming crystals and make it smooth. But most of those ingredients aren't particularly good for you. You probably shouldn't be eating them. I had the original, very healthful ice cream. Okay, now, we're going to have, I'm going to get tell you another, or I'm going to have a, what's called a rapid fire focus now. Rapid fire, have I ever done rapid fire in here?
No.
I've never used that term with you. Okay, in what kind of movies do you hear the phrase rapid fire? What kind of movies have the phrase rapid fire in them? What?
Like military movies.
Right. Well, rapid fire means nobody writes anything. A rapid fire focus is where nobody writes anything. We just have rapid fire questions and answers. All right, now, two peanut butter jars, identical. C and D. C is full and D isn't. Okay, the problem to be solved here is, why is C full and D not full? All right, what would you like to know? Obviously, there was a manipulated variable because I started with two identical jars. That's a control variable. Something different happened that caused D not to be full. What would you like to ask, Tanner?
Does D not have a lid or evaporated?
They neither one had a lid. The only reason they have lids right now is so it won't spill when I carry it in my box. They neither one had a lid during the experiment. But no, the other part of your question, no, D did not evaporate. Kendall?
Did you pour some out of D?
Huh?
Did you pour any?
I didn't pour any out of D, no. What do you think, Emily?
Are we supposed to do it on the new recipe?
What?
Are we supposed to do it on the new recipe?
No, you don't have to do any more writing.
Oh.
It's a rapid fire. Jonathan?
Did you feel D all going up?
I feel D, they were both completely full at the start of the experiment. No lids. Now there's something else that's very important you don't know yet. What's important that you don't know yet, Jeremy?
Does E and C and D.
C and D
have completely water in them?
C and D are just water. Right. Now that's one of the important things you need to know. C and D are just water. Okay. Now we're trying to figure out why D isn't full and C is. What would you like to know, Emily?
Was D filled with hot water and C filled with cold water?
No. They were both filled with room temperature water. Okay, now that's not as ridiculous a question as it might sound because She didn't know the answer. When is a question ridiculous? Did I tell you that? What's the only time a question is ridiculous? Kendall? If you already know the answer. Have you ever met anybody that asked a lot of questions they knew the answers to?
Yeah.
So have I. Okay. All right. Well, obviously something different happened to one of them. What, Jessica?
Oh,
it's they didn't have lids. They didn't have lids. Well, I obviously did something different to one of them. Okay, well, I'm going to have to help you out here a little bit, I guess, because you seem stumped. Okay. Here's C, peanut butter jar. Here's D, an identical peanut butter jar. What did I do next? What's the first thing I did? This is D. I guess you knew that was D, right? What did I do next, Stevie? I put water in it. Right. Okay. Who knows? Who thinks they know what I did next? What did I do next, Jackie? No, they didn't have lids. What do you think I did next after I filled them with water? Emily? I froze them. Okay. Now, a day later, I opened the freezer. Who can tell me how C looked a day later after it was frozen? How should I change the diagram, Darby?
It should have been 8% higher.
8% higher. She remembered that 8%. That water expands by 8%. Okay. Who can tell me how D looked when I opened the freezer? Emily?
8% higher.
It was 8% higher also. Has there been a manipulated variable applied yet?
No.
No. All right. What do you think I did next? The manipulated variable comes next. What did I do next that was a manipulated variable, do you think? Emily?
Did you keep one in the freezer and take one out?
No. What do you think I did next, Jackie? Or Jessica?
Did you apply laundry?
No. Tanner.
Did you heat them?
Huh?
Did you
heat
them?
No, I didn't heat them. Jeremy?
Did you take them out and then you took D and cut off the 8% that got frozen?
You can cut ice with a saw. Like, cut that off and threw it away. Now, ice is solid water. What percent of the solid water was I throwing away? What percent, Wyatt?
8%.
8%. I was throwing away 8%. What percent of the liquid water would that be? What?
8%.
8%. Right. Okay. So, Then after I took the ice off, what did I do? After I took the ice off, what did I do, Jeremy?
You let them melt.
I let them melt. Okay, now when they melted, they became a liquid, right? Everybody knows that?
Yeah.
Okay. The level of the water after they melted ended up at either level 1, 2, or 3. 1, 2, or 3. All right, I'm going to have you vote on C first. How many think that when they melted, the level of the water in C ended up at level 1? Level 2? Level 3? Everybody voted for 2, and that's right. See, if you expand it by 8%, somebody ought to be able to figure this out. I don't think I've told you this yet, this period. How much does ice shrink if it melts? What percent does ice shrink if it melts? Mason?
8%.
So you freeze it and you add 8% to its volume, you thaw it and you subtract 8% from its volume, it ends up where it started. I'll bet a lot of your parents don't know that. All right. You're going to vote now on where this one ended up. How many say that D ended up at level 1, level 2, level 3? Right, level 3. How far below the top is that? How far?
8%.
8% below. Okay. All right. Well, freezing water expands by 8%, and that creates a lot of pressure enough to break that jar. But you may be surprised at this. That pressure is enough to break steel pipes, too. It's enough to break steel water pipes if it gets cold enough. Now, how many of you live right here in the town of Meadville? How many of you live? Oh, well, about half of you. Okay. So you're city kids, right? Okay. All right. Here's your house. And if it's built according to code, it's got a crawl space underneath with openings. Who knows what a crawl space is for? I'm going to tell you. That's what a crawl space is for. Say it as soon as you know it.
Crawling.
Crawling. Crawl space is for crawling. Who wants to crawl? Who wants to crawl in a crawl space? What kind of person would want to crawl in a crawl space? If you know what kind of person that would tend to crawl in a crawl space, somebody besides your parents. Who knows somebody that would crawl in a crawl space? Tanner?
Right.
Some kind of electrician or a plumber or a carpenter or somebody like that. You have something else to say? What? Oh, you crawl in the crawl space?
I was under my house.
How many of you have ever been in your crawl space? Here's part of what you should have seen. Out here on the street, if you live in the city of Eatonville, there's a big water line called the water main. It's a really big water pipe, 6 feet down, so it won't freeze. Okay, there's a smaller pipe coming up here to your water meter, which is where the water company reads it every month to tell how much water you use. And then there's a pipe that goes under the crawl space, under the floor, and then that branches out to all of the rooms that have water, like bathrooms and a laundry room and a kitchen, like that. Those pipes are all under the floor. They're not in the heated part of the house. They're under the floor. The crawl space isn't heated in most homes. Okay? Now here's what sometimes happens when we get down to 20 degrees or below, which happens once in a while out here. Those pipes will freeze. So you open the faucet and nothing comes out. Why doesn't anything come out? Why doesn't anything come out, Chase?
Because it's frozen.
Okay. All right, so as long as it stays frozen, you won't get any water out of that faucet. But the weather warms up, and sometimes the homeowner will hear a gushing sound under the floor. What's the gushing sound? What's the gushing sound caused by? Emily?
Slush?
Carly?
The ice moving over.
No. Jeremy?
When it expanded, broke the pipe.
And what's the gushing sound? Water gushing out of the broken pipe. Okay, now, you're the homeowner and you hear this water gushing out of this broken pipe. Give me an adjective that would describe how you would feel at that moment. One adjective that might describe how you would feel when you heard gushing water underneath your floor. One adjective. There's a lot of them, but I can think of a couple of the most important. What's one, Nathan? How would you feel?
I just want to go down there and fix it.
I want one word. I don't think any of your one words would fit. Okay. All right. Tia.
Freaked out?
I guess if you put a hyphen in that one word. Janelle?
Flood.
I want an adjective. That's a noun. Yeah. Who knows one adjective that might describe how you'd feel at that point? Emily?
Scared.
Scared. Okay, good.